In this video, we'll cover the fundamental concepts of fertilization and implantation, two crucial processes in human reproduction that lead to the development of a new individual. Fertilization is the process by which a sperm cell from the male and an egg cell or the ovum from the female unite to form a zygote. It typically occurs in the fallopian tube shortly after ovulation. Here's a step-by-step breakdown of the fertilization process. Ovulation, a highly regulated process in the female reproductive system, is triggered by a surge in luteinizing hormone and follicle-stimulating hormone from the anterior pituitary gland. The egg is released from the dominant ovarian follicle into the fallopian tube, which usually occurs around the middle of the menstrual cycle. Sperm cells, produced in the testes, are deposited into the female reproductive tract during sexual intercourse. They must navigate through the cervix, which has thick mucus that becomes thinner and more receptive to sperm as ovulation approaches. Some sperm may be lost or die along the way, but millions are typically released in a single ejaculation to increase the chances of reaching the egg. The fusion of the sperm and egg membranes is a complex process. Sperm cells are equipped with a specialized structure called the acrosome, which contains enzymes to help penetrate the egg's protective layers. When a sperm reaches the egg, the acrosome releases these enzymes, allowing the sperm to penetrate the egg's zona pellucida and ultimately fuse with the egg's plasma membrane. Once the sperm penetrates the zona pellucida, the egg undergoes a process called the cortical reaction, where calcium ions are released, creating a barrier that prevents other sperm from entering. This ensures that only one sperm fertilizes the egg. Once a sperm successfully fuses with the egg's genetic material, that includes 23 chromosomes from the mother, combines with that of the sperm, that also includes 23 chromosomes from the father, resulting in a total of 46 chromosomes in the zygote. The zygote is diploid, containing a complete set of chromosomes from both parents. This new cell begins to divide through mitosis, forming a multicellular structure. Beyond the cortical reaction, additional mechanisms within the egg and zona pellucida prevent polyspermy. These include fast block and slow block mechanisms, which further ensure that only one sperm successfully fertilizes the egg. After fertilization, the zygote begins to divide and develop into a blastocyst, a small, hollow structure comprised of a cluster of cells. The blastocyst then needs to implant itself into the lining of the uterus for further development. Here's how implantation occurs. The process of blastocyst formation involves the rapid division of cells. As the blastocyst develops, the trophoblast cells differentiate into two distinct layers: the inner cytotrophoblast and the outer syncytiotrophoblast. The inner cell mass will give rise to the embryo itself. The blastocyst travels through the fallopian tube into the uterine cavity. It eventually approaches the thickened, receptive endometrial lining of the uterus. The blastocyst's outer cells, the syncytiotrophoblast, produce enzymes that help break down the uterine lining, allowing the blastocyst to burrow into the endometrial tissue. The process of apposition and adhesion between the trophoblast and the endometrial lining is critical for successful implantation. Once adhesion occurs, the syncytiotrophoblast continues to invade the endometrial tissue, creating spaces known as lacunae, which will eventually become part of the maternal blood supply. This process ensures that the developing embryo receives essential nutrients and oxygen from the mother's bloodstream. The trophoblast cells eventually differentiate further, forming the chorionic villi, finger-like projections that will become the placenta. The placenta plays a crucial role in providing a barrier between the maternal and fetal bloodstreams while facilitating the exchange of gases, nutrients, and waste products. The successful implantation of the blastocyst triggers hormonal changes, including the production of human chorionic gonadotropin, which is detected in pregnancy tests. This hormone helps maintain the corpus luteum in the ovary, ensuring the production of progesterone to sustain the pregnancy. In summary, fertilization involves the fusion of male and female gametes to form a zygote, while implantation is the process by which the blastocyst attaches to and embeds itself within the uterine lining. Both processes are essential for the initiation of pregnancy and the subsequent development of a new human life. And that's all for this video. We hope you found this video informative and helpful. In our next video, we'll look at the first trimester of pregnancy. Stay tuned, subscribe to our channel, and hit that notification bell to be the first to know when the next video drops. Until next time.